Welcome back to my channel. Don't mind me, I just woke up, but I really wanted to vlog for you guys. Today is the 5th of December. I had really wild dreams of possibly doing Vlogmas, but essentially I have been, because I've been doing these really cute little cooking videos for you guys on my Instagram. If you're not following me on Instagram, I don't know what you're waiting for. It's at onnet.titira. But anyway, today is a Saturday. I'm not working. I'm working tomorrow evening. So I just thought I should make use of a free day. So right now I'm making breakfast, and then I'm going to go out for something I've always wanted to do, which is horseback riding. Basically, you're like safari watching on a horse. A little bit scary because I have never ridden a horse before. I do not know the basics of riding a horse. But we'll see. Anyway, basically just spend the day with me. I don't know if I will do like vlogmas, but I will be very engaging throughout December. My Instagram will always have something going on, and I'll try and do like a vlog a week thing, but definitely I won't promise to be on here with my camera every day, just because my work doesn't allow that sort of thing. I don't even have an end of year break like everybody else, but I'll do my best. Anyway, yeah. Happy December! Brown blouse, my jeans, and I was told to wear like boots or shoes with like a little heel at the back, because that's apparently ideal for horse riding. So I'll show you my shoes in a little bit. So yeah, see you guys soon. Bye. Just got here, did the registration and all that good stuff. I tried to put in a helmet, but it looks like it's too small, so they're trying to get me a bigger one, so we'll see. Here comes the bride. What a beautiful horsey! I'm on the horsey. His name is Butuba, right?
Yeah.
Does that mean Bunchu?
No. Grey. Grey.
Hey, naka sibira ke Bunchu.
Sibira.
Hara de motu motu.
Na la ke miroro ro sibira sake.
Ah, sama lada.
Gom lada na go go sama lada.
Okay.
Oh,
Skittles, welcome back. I just got back home. It was a really, really cool outing. My horse was very well behaved, except for one part where the tour guide was like, oh, just kick it and then it will catch up. Next thing I know, the horse is in the air and I'm literally like bouncing up and down. That was scary. Near-death experience. All in all, it was a good experience for somebody who's never ever ridden before. But yeah, I really enjoyed it. 100% recommend it to anybody. And please do... Sorry, my reel just fell. Please do support the guy who basically took us through. My friend recommended him to me. And I really want to plug him and recommend him to you guys. Because you guys already know what the tourism sector is facing right now. Kshubile, like it's bad. So... if you're in Mawung, I know a lot of people are planning on coming down here for the holidays. Please do just hit him up. He's very affordable, $200 for an hour. And I think that's all you need to do. Like, why are you going to be willing to be on a horse for 2-3 hours? 1 hour is more than enough. So yes, please just get in touch with him and do that. It's a fair way out of town. It's actually close to where I used to live, but I had no idea that it's so much further. So you'd need a good 4x4 to get there. You probably can get there with a small car, but you need to be very careful and you do run the risk of getting stuck. Otherwise, really good experience. 10 out of 10. Really cool. They'll guide you if you've never ridden before. The guy guides you and, you know, he teaches you what to do. It wasn't dangerous at all. Like, I had visions of myself getting fractures and falling off and all sorts of things, but it was really, really, really enjoyable, safe, helmets on, everything, precautions were taken. Highly recommend. Now I'm back home, plan for the rest of the day. I'll just have lunch, chill, catch up on like series and stuff, just relax. Tomorrow I'm working, so I'm not trying to do the most. But yeah, I'll try and put this out today. I'll try and edit and put it up today. Yeah, later. Okay guys, so for lunch today, I'm going to show you guys how I make this gourmet hot dog. Literally takes me back to those nice juicy hot dogs that you would grab in New York on the side of the road. Katlego, if you're watching, you'd remember we had a really good one together. But anyway, I have sausages. I don't have them here. I'll show you guys in a bit. I'm gonna put those on the grill, and then I have my hot dog buns, nice and soft. These are my all-time favorites, regular degulas. I'm going to basically dice my pickled onions and dill pickles because they're basically ready to go. And then, what's a hot dog darling without good old yellow mustard? This is actually an American brand, so I have no doubt that it will taste as authentic as possible. So yes, let's get started, darling. So our sausage is already on the grill. I've just put the heat nice and low, so that by the time we're done preparing in the kitchen, these will be ready, looking nice and scrumptious already. We're good, yes, we're good. I know I look different now. I had to get comfortable. So I just wanted to show you guys with my hot dogs. I cut them in the middle, but not all the way through. I don't know if you guys can see, right? Instead of what we would normally do on the side, I'm just going to cut them in the middle, but not all the way through. And then right now I am dicing my pickles. I'm sure you can see them there. And my onions. So that's what you guys are going to be seeing now. Because I know myself and I know I'm clumsy with the ketchup, I'm just gonna put a little block on my chopping board and then carry it from there. Like so. Now cheese time. I'm using cheddar cheese. So you just want to sprinkle a little bit. This is the grated one, okay? Sprinkle a little bit into that. You already know what's going to happen to this cheese when we pop this in the oven. Alright, so I just quickly put everything else away, just left with what I need. Now I'm just going to check if the sausages are ready. Come with me, come with me. The lights, darling. The lights. Let's see. Ooh, I think we're ready. So I did one already for you guys. And then I'm just going to speed through the rest. So basically, I don't want to touch anymore because my hands are holding camera contamination. But inside, the cheese is nice and melted. So what I want to do is take my diced pickles and my pickled onions and just basically put them under. I'm avoiding putting them on top or on the side because then they would fall off. So you put them under and then you put the sausage and then you just lay your mustard. Yeah, as much as you want. Like, I want a whole lot. So this is just for looks, for vibes, for ambiance, but in actual fact I'm probably gonna put a whole lot more. So yes, let me try and set you guys up so you can see me doing the rest of them. Okay, I just wanted to show you guys the final product. Yes, so this is my final this is the final product, the final picture. This is my gourmet hot dog. Love how it turned out. I don't know what I didn't show you guys. After putting the mustard, I went ahead and put on a little bit of barbecue sauce. That's why it's looking a bit different from what I showed you earlier. But yes, this is it. Or not, I know it looks like now I'm just content fishing, but during the week I had this it's just a chronic back pain that I have just beside my left shoulder blade. So yes, the gait is working finally. It's been down for a few days. Yeah, so this is just a pain I have like since forever. I remember since med school, if I ever sit for too long studying and whatever, I would get it. So this week it's just been really, 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 really bad. So I was gonna go on the day I was post call, which was on, I think it was on Wednesday, but I missed my appointment. And then I was just like, let me just save money. Rapid the pain, I think it needed to demand. So then I was just like, whatever, it's fine. So today I was just chilling and then I felt it and I'm like, you know what, I have nothing that I'm doing. And granted, it will make really good content to sort of just like tie the vlog together. So we're driving to Crocodile Camp. I couldn't call them back to make an appointment again, but it's really close to my house. It's like literally a 2-minute drive to my house from my house. So I'm just gonna drive there and hope I can get squeezed in, and if I can, obviously I'll show you guys the massage. Cresta Maroon also does massages, but I've heard they cost like $600 or something like that. I am sorry, all I need is just a good 45 minute to 1 hour deep tissue massage and I will be right. So that the hell, I'm not looking to pay that much money. If it was a whole package, like a whole hot stone Thai massage situation, then I'd be willing to pay crazy amounts. So anyway, I'm about to get onto the main road and I am not a very good multitasker, specifically when it comes to driving. So I'll catch you guys when I'm in Crocodile Camp. problem getting maske le go ikwadisa. I absolutely hate that stuff, but I know it's for a good purpose. Let me just wear my mask. So yeah guys, I think that's why I'm gonna close up this vlog. There's really nothing interesting that I'm going to do after this. I'm just gonna eat, probably take a nap because the itis always gets me good, and then after that just like catch up on TV and stuff and just rest before to rest before to yes, I hope you're having a good December. I don't know, just be grateful for everything that you have. I think that's my motto for 2020. I saw a quote somewhere that said 2020 is the year that people thought they were gonna get everything they've always wanted, but instead were taught to appreciate everything that they have. So on that note, thank you for watching. I love you guys so much. Take care and mwah!